As you worship there, as you give your offerings and your tithes here, as you respond to music or praises, look up, in one mikono nju, you are connecting with the altar. As you listen to the words spoken from here, you are connecting with the altar. Then there is God Himself connecting with you. That point of contact is what we call an altar. We have talked about that in the past. Now, another thing I've never mentioned to you. Whenever the terms, listen to these terms, covenant, you honor that term, covenant, oath, swearing, blood, or sacrifice is used, an altar is a subject. Some parts in the Bible, as I shall show you here, those ones are used. The word altar is not mentioned. In other places, blood is mentioned, or sacrifice, or swearing, or oath, or covenant. I want to assure you, if either of those terms or all of those terms exist, it is the altar in question. You can mark that and say there is an altar here. It's an altar. Those terms, covenant, oath, swearing, blood, sacrifice. Look, you know those ones. There is an altar there. Now, most stubborn problems, this is what I want to talk about today. Most stubborn problems in life have a source in an existing or active altar. Most problems in life, church, they have a source in an existing or active altar. An altar is active. And this altar is demanding sacrifice. Do you know what I'm going to say? I'm going to say,
I'm beating the bush. Dry sterile, you know what's going on? Dry season. Kiangazi. Mvua ukikosekana for a long time. Wazee walikuwa wanaenda kwa mlima kutoa nini? Dabini. Wanaenda kuchinja mbuzi. And I'm telling you, mvua ilikuwa inakuja. If I remember the sisters, check in your own village. So I want to say this. Most of the stubborn problems in life, stubborn. I'm talking about stubborn problems. Whether for a nation or whether for individuals, they have a source in another somewhere. So please engage yourself in this. If I have to teach you in details, tunaweza kukaa hapa the whole day, tunakula, tunarudi pole pole. I don't have that luxury of time. Because unaona nampatia matirio nyingi. Nasema badali muwe nazo, somewhere one day utafunuka macho, uelewe kile ilikuwa nazungumzia. Na wende ulize Mungu, utafute Mungu. Because if I go slow, I may take over 2 years talking about the same thing, which is too much. So understand that. Now, a few examples will prove this about the stubborn problems in life. And you are not strangers to problems. As long as you are living in this world, you are not strangers to stubborn problems. Problems that defy even prayer. I think some of you have seen when you are ministering to some people here. Remember, several cases. I go over here, I say, I challenge the altar invoked. Nani mtu alikuwa normal tu. I challenge the altar invoked. The person falls down. Mmoja alianguka nikifikiria atasimama. She took off. we never preached.
Si tu comprends na we. Na alikuwa no more.
The moment I challenged the altar, invoked, she fell down. Waking up, she took off.
Wengine alikuwa na hiyo mashinda huko akasema, "Wamemwambia atoroke."
Unajua they cooperate.
Eh? Biona hiyo mapepo.
Now, inaongea.
Wamemwambia, "Mama ina ni yule."
Nakwambia naye.
Kamehama.
I remember watu walipiga nduru kwa sababu watoto walikuwa pale. Watoto wasikanyangwe.
Kaka toka.
I think Brother Vincent.
If I remember, Brother Vincent kept the mic there. Ran after her.
Wakafika pale. Kwa barabara akakuta barabara.
Kamama kama kwekea karate.
Cheza na mimi nikutwange mwana.
Amburu belt.
Mbapisa na kashika.
Akaita wazee wakuje kumsaidia.
Kalikuwa na nguvu.
Bwana asifiwe.
Sasa any stubborn problem,
you can take it one to the bank.
Any stubborn problem
as a source in an existing order.
Hata wale wasiojua ni order gani anja kuja office to discuss. Sijui kama tulimalizia alimaanisha tu kuhubiri siku hiyo. Tu and half hours to go tunamwombea. Sijui kama tulimaliza.
But there was an order.
Sielewi kama alienda huko au
hata sikuwa na revelation ya waters that time, the one I have now.
Now, are the examples will help you to understand.
Number one, famine in Israel, 2 Samuel 21, verse 1 to 4. Verse 1 to 4.
Now, there is a famine in Israel for 3 years, year after year.
I have preached over this several times when I was reading about the curses.
But now I'm talking about something different.
David could not get why this thing is so persistent.
So the Bible says, he inquired of the Lord. And the Lord answered him.
I like that.
Would you like it to stubborn?
I'm provoking you to.
You get in with God.
Didn't went to God.
Hakuna mtu anaweza kuniambia shida hii inatoka wapi.
Kumbe wewe
your great great grandfather married his sister.
Nani atakwambia hiyo na wamekufa wote?
Umetoka kwa huo uzao.
Great great grand what?
Eh?
Father aliwa sister yake.
Au zaliwa na baba na msichana wake.
Who ever tell you that?
They are not alive, they died.
So David knew there is someone who can tell me those deep secrets. It is the Lord.
He inquired of the Lord, and the Lord answered him.
Akamwambia Ishinda, ni aso, and his bland house, because he killed the Gibeonites.
Now, if you want, notice that Saul and his bland house, notice blood.
That means hapo kuna agano. Hapa kuna madhabahu.
Then you go to how, who are these Gibeonites whom it was so serious to kill?
You know, in those days, when you went to war, you were around to kill.
Like he saw in Ezeb, he killed the Gibeonites who are living among the children of Israel.
So if you read that account of Saul killing the Gibeonites,
I don't locate in scriptures. See the pattern?
Why he actually killed them?
Maybe I'm missing somewhere.
But the record shows he killed them in a zeal for God.
But if you go to Joshua 9, verse 4 all the way to 19, you'll see where the Gibeonites began to live among the children of Israel.
Yeah?
They cheated Joshua and their leaders, and they made a covenant to them, and they swore to them that they will not kill them. Later on, thinking they come from far, they found they were just neighbors there where they were conquering Canaan.
But they had already sworn to them.
So they began to live among them. You can read the story there.
The point I want to bring to you, that this thing they entered into in the Gibeonites was a covenant. There was swearing. There was eating.
So that's an altar. an altar. They built an altar.
So now, there's a problem now trying to bring famine in the land of Israel. After many years, after Saul had died, many years, kumbe kuna kitu kiko. Kulikuwa na kitu kiko. It never did anything with them or Saul. It waited until the reign of David. Let me tell you, I don't know whether you're understanding what I'm telling you. I am saying, oh, it's not okay. Dig in deep a bit about your life, your family. Dig a bit. Wacha kutoseka mimi baba yangu anaitwa Njoka. Oh, sorry. Kulumu anaitwa Njoka. Sorry, wanja. Kana mbale. Mtu mirewa mbale. Kana eguna. Jee, utimu tuweta wa eguna. Eguna ni machu kanare. Utisoseke hapo. Eguna ni mwana wawo. Iyo nuwele, ale mwana wawo, mbira lukonoro eto. Wakikosa kuambia ukweli, ukiwa unaona shida ambayo inashika, go to God, He will give you to the faithful generation, what really transpired in your family. I thank God, I thank the Holy Ghost. I thank God for the Bible. So, David once knew that the problem caused by a king in Israel, and he was a king. He went to the Gibeonites. Akauliza, what do I do for you? Restitution. Kurekebisha kile kimeharibika. Nifanye nini mtubariki? Bariki wana wa Israeli. Walisema, no one will die for our sake. Lakini wale walituua, we want 7 sons. Wakuje, we hang them before the sun. David said, I will give you. Again, I got 7 grandsons who are so great grandsons. How can I make kuja wewe, kuja, kuja wewe, na baba yako, kuja. Unakuja kuokotwa. Hata ujui kile kilicho kinafanyika. And they were hanged. That total demanded a sacrifice. So, I mean, it couldn't be even demanded as a sacrifice. Ujui. You know, it's easier for some of us to die than others. Unaweza kwa nini? Why is someone so exposed? Eh? Why are you so vulnerable? Kwa nini maisha yako is hanging in danger throughout? It couldn't be. There's demand of a restitution because of a mistake made by the great grandfathers. Now, ujui? Ujui kile kinaendelea? It's important to check. Then you rectify with the new covenant that we have with Christ. Unaona, David alikataa kuchukua kijana wa nani? Wa Jonathan. Alikuwa anaitwa? Mephibosheth au Isboseth? Mephi. Akamchukua akamficha asikuwe hanged because of another covenant that David had with who? His father. So the covenant David had with his father is stronger than the covenant the grandfather had or the mistakes he did. So akamchua akamficha because of another stronger what? Covenant. That's similar wherever how your life is played around by covenants. Now wherever ile agano Mungu amefanya na Yesu on your behalf. You must claim this. Wadunguna asam because Jesus died. Hakuna kitu kama hicho uongo. If that's the truth, hatungekuwa na wenye dhambi siku hizi. People will be automatically saved, but they are not. Everyone has a responsibility to receive what Jesus is offering. You are here because you received that offer of salvation. Because you are here. So it's not automatic. The way people say, praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. That's a stubborn problem in Israel. Another. You can read it further, either wherever. You don't have time to read and I think you are reading there on the screen. I mean, I don't have one. Another example. Plague in Israel. Plague.
Prege nini? Njanga. Ale. Prege de kabongodi, kabongodi na chupa. Ok, il ment. Plague, quoi que soit. Hein? Un monde de carrière en bois, vous savez, soyez au cas. Ou bien âme. Il est en ligne. Djanga. Nadiwa. Vous êtes en bois, vous êtes en bois. Oh! Kuna djangasi. Kiagasi. Nakuna djanga. Cha, janga. Where is my mother? My mother is a brana convenia. Hallelujah. There was a plague in Israel. A plague. First Chronicles 21. Now the Bible says, Satan provoked David. Is that so? I like First Chronicles. Oh, Satan stood up against Israel and provoked David to number what? Now, if you read the account in Samuel, it says God himself is the one who did what? God is the one who provoked David. No. So the two seems to say it's God. No, it's not God. Wanna ask me? Now, Nathan won a. The issue here is why did David order a census? Why? Usually census used to be done when they were going to war. To accept what I want to about, who are over 40, 20 years, who can go to what? To war. That's when what we are going to say. Hata kwa jamii, wakati mnakula chakula mkua wengi, mama ataki uhesabu watu 1, 2, 3. Umeambiwa hivyo? Unaona unasimama hapa, unaona mtu anafanya hivi? Amemalizana wewe. Against 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No. It is biblical. So there are two reasons. When Satan stood against Easter, he provoked the king. When the devil stands against the church, Jesus Tabernacle Church, he provokes the pastor in charge. Makosa ya bishop ni makosa ya kanisa yote. You come on and you. Is it risky for you to come for a service without praying for the pastor who is pastoring you? Makosa yake ni makosa ya kanisa yote. Don't brag there vile wewe au shikani na huyo bishop. Au muerewi ana mpango. And you are very bold. Omea yeye au na huyo mpango. Satan stood against Israel, he provoked David. In two respects. The census, there was no reason for it. Number two, the motive. Why number? Because when he told Joab to number, he said, I want to know the number. I want to know it. That was not the reason why. What were required is a big one. Joab said now, my lord, even if there are tens of thousands, are they not my lord's the key? Why should this be a cause of sin before the Lord? He never had. The Bible says the king's one prevailed. Kama vile unaweza kuniambiwaise na kata. I said you do it, what I'm saying. So Joab went and tried to number them, akiwa ni comfortable, he obeyed, a military leader. He obeyed Mishoya, even never numbered it. Is it ready? The tribe of Levi never numbered it. Because the thing was bad to him. Job could perceive that David is bringing Israel to sin. Number two, the other mistake David did, he failed to offer a sacrifice required. There was a sacrifice that was required before you numbered the people. So the plague does fall, not fall on them. Exodus chapter 30, verse 12. It is specified what sacrifice was to offer. What is it were they to offer? Specified in the scripture. David ignored it. Notice the word sacrifice. Madhabahu tena. Kumbe, walikuwa njenga madhabahu hapo alia. Watoe sandaka, watoe dhabihu, dami mwagike. Hapo tena, kabla ya kuhesabu watu. Didn't he not what God had clearly specified? Because of those two mistakes, 70,000 men of Israel, verse 14, died. In fact, David is asking the Lord, I am the one who has sinned. Let your sword rise against me and my father's house. What have these sheep done? Oh, no, wow. That's it. You think the sheep have done nothing? They refuse to pray. The president makes a mess. You will taumwa, this is. The bishop makes a mistake. No taumwa. Oh, nakata kuomba. Kumombe. Mina mambia muombe. Unakata. Nasema si taomba. Si ta fast. You will taumwa. Bishop will taumwa. Down here on the moon. Si mimi nimekosea. Si uniue na familia yangu. God never answered it. 70,000. They are not innocent. They should have prayed for David. First of all, prayers, supplications and intercessions be made for all men. For kings and for all those who are in authority. Thank you for those who are coming to pray here. I may not have time to pray as required. Let me tell you. I'm supposed to spend 6 hours. See, I'm sitting there with Biblia, kuomba. Let me tell you, I want to pray, but there is a call which I must wait for. I can't switch on my phone. One has it. There are pressures from all over. God is my judge, but I have people who can cover up those hours of prayers so that God's purpose can be fulfilled. They can fast. They refuse to fast. Sawa. Kikiteremuka. God and bishop wangu kwa malamu akufe. Hata kufa. Hata kigia kwa dhambi. Ndelewa. Monto. Monto ni mungujia. Na alimeia ni katakati. Na ateko kuwa. Ateko kuwa. Ataendelea mpaka amalize. Kwa sababu amewahiwa mafuta. Lakini wale wataumwa ni wale wanapaswa kumshikilia kwa maombi. Kumubeba kwa maombi. Hao wataumwa. Kwa sababu akifanya vyema, baraka zinawaangukia. My Bible saying about another bishop from another church. Mshirika akatoka mbali akaenda kwake. Bishop alikuwa anazungumza hivyo. Akamletea 8,000 tithe. I'm a bishop. Nimeona hii ni yako nikuletee. Ameacha pastor wake kule. Pastor wake akistruggle. Ana mashinda, lakini amekataa kumpatia tithe. Apatie bishop mkuu. Akamuliza, akachukua. Hiyo ikamsumbua, akampigia yule pastor. Akamwambia, "Could you be having some challenge?" Akamwambia, "Bishop, hebu nikwambie ukweli. Watoto wangu wako shule za hizi. Nyumba ninafungiwa." Akaambia mashida yale anayo. Yule pastor, ana pastor nani? Ule mshirika. Anaona ule atapelekea ni yule mkubwa. Yule anaomba na yeye kila siku, anamsaidia, anamnyima fungu la 10. Anapelekea nani? Yule bishop alichukua hiyo tithe akampelekea hiyo pastor. Yote. Yeah, no. responsibility ni ya Bible. I will never forget one time to go to a man. A visiting preacher came and preached in the denomination. One brother who was there had impartia 50,000 those years. 50,000. 50. Na mi wakati nikuwa na nunua gari ya tagari yangu ilichomeka, alipeana 2,050. Fungu lake la 10 alikuwa anatafuta kile atanunua na hiyo fungu. Alimba imbota ngita, erect ngita. Akanambia, pastor, I was thinking and that idea, ninunue hii ngita. Nikamwambia nunua tu. Ati hiyo ni tithe sasa. Ameona akiletea pastor atakula. Hata utamia vizuri na ana akili ya kutumia pesa nyingi. Na wakati alikuwa na shida, nilikuwa natoka kwangu saa 8 usiku kwenda kwa nyumba yao. Anapatia mgeni 50,000. So what I'm saying is your duty to pray. Lord, why this sheep? What have they done? They have done it, did it. They should have prayed for you. Usivanye ujinga na upusi na upumbavu. Sione. You think it's easy to talk to people like this? It's easy to give a wrong word. Utenemuka. Utenemuka? Utenemuka. Kwa rurime. Kwa rurime. Kwa rurime. You require to be controlled, monitoring by intercession. Usiharibu mambo. Aduna achiriwa. Someone becomes wild, he casts his people, and it's not aware what he is doing. So the plague, David knows those mistakes. To avert this plague, that's my point. To avert this plague, a sacrifice was demanded in that and in that another. Verses 18:28 of 1 Chronicles 21. How will this crisis be averted? In the back, God gave him three choices. I will be a chagua moja hizo. I can say my death before in the hands of God, not in the hands of man. You can read that story. The hand of God was the plague. So, an angel appeared. He told him, go. They are not at the threshing floor of honor. The other account in Samuel says Arauna, something. It's the same person. They are not and with it a sacrifice. They went over the sacrifice there. And the Lord hand and fire came from heaven and consumed the sacrifice. The plague was stopped. The question I'm having today in this service. Is it possible the problem we have today is because of the census we had? Was it 2018 or 2019? Census yare? Eh? COVID what? COVID? Well, I don't know about the other nations of the world, but that question came to me. And if I get access the president, I will tell him and I will read for him the scriptures in the book of Exodus, chapter 30, verse 12 and 16. Kwa nini unahesabu watu na unja tuwa sandaka? Na unja tuwa dhabihu. That hiyo kitu ilikuja leo to me when I was preparing. Could it be? Could it be if we did not do that census? Or if we offer the sacrifice, the hands of the government offer the sacrifice to God? Could it be that Corona would have escaped us and just gone round and left Kenya alone? It's a question of growing people. Could it be? Mystic of Arinda. We are watching people dying over and over again. So and then according to the instructions of the Lord. Verse 26, the Lord answered from heaven. Notice. And not a sacrifice. Notice, they were supposed to offer a sacrifice earlier. That means there was an altar that demanded a sacrifice, which was not offered when they were being counted. Could it be? Hallelujah. Upon the machine, because I have two things to share, so I have to stop. So we shall share again, no problem. So I will come to practical application of that on specific people so that you can connect with it. You are not the president, you are not the king. But now I'll come to specific people in the machine. Located to the altar. So the next one, you can call it part two. This one, visit, you can call this one part one. Not part one, session one. Call it session one. The other one, call it session two because it's part of this. One answer here. Hallelujah.